know we got a good day for it.
You bet, Hank.
Well, I'm a long-whiskered catfish, Hank Foreman.
Hello, Lem.
Thought you was back in Kansas.
Got too populated. So I took the advice of my old boss, Horace Greeley. He said, go west, young man. And here we are, the press on wheels, aiming to cover the ground like a setting score.
You fellas all ready to go?
Sure, you won't have no trouble. Just settlers and speculators here. Anybody else, we rode out.
Good.
Hello, Mitch.
Hello, Judge. Well, how's the ride?
Mighty interesting, but I still prefer a home. Be Steve Lewis.
Howdy.
Oh, Steve. Come here a minute, will you? Boys, meet Steve Lewis.
Howdy, fellas.
Howdy.
Steve is going to run the auction so that we'll know everything is going to be done my way. Isn't that right, Steve?
Yeah, sure.
Nice and legal.
That's right.
Nice and legal. Now, look. I want all the river lots. That is, the ones that are shaded on the map. Now, Steve here is going to be taken with a sudden affliction. That is, he won't be able to hear anybody when they bid. Unless they're standing down close, and that's where you boys ought to be, do you understand?
Right, Pa.
Good. All right, everybody, come down this way. The auction's down here.
So Jim Cork's running the auction for the railroad, huh?
Yeah.
Wonder the tracks don't curl up.
My friends, fellow pioneers, and all you elegant ladies. You've walked, you've rode, you've come by train. I know you've had a long, hard trip, but that's over with. We're going to hold this auction, and we're going to found the town, and we're going to build it up until New York and Chicago has something to shoot at. Now, you buy yourselves one of these lots today, and within a week's time, you'll be able to sell it for 100 times what you paid for it. Now, I know you're all anxious to get started, so I'll introduce you to Mr. Steve Lewis, my lawyer. He's going to run the auction. Now, you'll have to speak up a little bit loud when you bid, because he's just a little hard of hearing. Mr. Lewis.
Hey! All right, folks, you've all had a chance to study the map, so let's make it quick. Let's start with lot number 57. What do I hear? What am I bid?
I bid 50.
60. 75.
I'm bid $50. Do I hear more?
I said 75.
50 it is, then. Sold to this gentleman for $50. Step over that table, make your payment, and get your quit claim deed.
What did he say? Is that our lot? Did you hear him?
Well, get in there and find out.
Wait a minute. If that's not 55,
$85.
$100.
$100.
I'll pay him the pieces. I bid $100 for that lot.
Well, I'm sorry, friend. I didn't hear you.
You heard me. You ain't as deaf as he's.
Now, hold on, my friend. At this moment, you're breaking the law, attempting to intimidate a legal representative of the railroad by threats both implied and spoken. And according to the verdict handed down in the case of State versus Peckham, you're in grave danger of standing liable for a term of not less than 4, no more than 6 years in prison.
Prison? Who's in prison?
Peckham languished there for 5 years.
Well, look, I don't want any trouble with the law. I just want a chance to make a bid in one of these lots.
Why, yes, my friend. All in good order. All in good order.
All right. That's all I want. Thanks.
Smart fella, eh, Mitch? You know what he said to me the first time I met him? He says, I'm a lawyer, available and interested in all sorts of genteel skullduggery.
Where's he from?
Albany.
Never heard of it.
It's someplace in the East.
Are you all done at 50, then sold to this gentleman for $50. Step over to that table, partner. And now for lot number 38, a beautiful garden spot on the river. What am I bid? What do I hear?
$50.
$50 bid. Do I hear more?
One moment, please. I bid $75 for that lot. Excuse me, please. I do hope you're all going to be gentlemen and not bid anymore, because I want that particular lot.
Well, sister, just who are you bidding for?
Why, I'm not bidding for anybody except myself.
Then what do you want the land for?
Well, since you're nice enough to ask me, I'll tell you. I'm buying for speculation. I come from Philadelphia. My folks were Quakers. They're both dead, though. My mother died of heart trouble, arteriosclerosis. It's rather difficult to pronounce, but my, it really is a dreadful disease. My father's heart was quite good, but after my mother died, he was never quite the same. He finally came down with sugar in the blood. Did you ever have that? No. No, I guess you wouldn't. You look quite strong. Well, anyway, my parents left me some money. So there I was, an orphan, with nothing to do but teach school forever in Philadelphia. And then my uncle told me about this place, and so here I am. And I have all the money my parents left me right here in this bag. It's $500, except $34.60. That's what the trip costs so far. And if I have to, I'll bid all my money on that lot. So now I do hope you're all going to be gentlemen and not bid any more.
Is this real?
There appear to be a number of children here. Yes, I might even put up a schoolhouse. After all, the town is going to be all you said. They'll probably need some learning. Don't you think so?
Oh, go on. Let the little lady have it.
Why, certainly. No one would think of competing with you, miss. Would they, Jim?
Aye.
Sold to the young lady. What's your name, ma'am?
My name is Annie Morgan.
Thank you.
Step over the table, make your payment, and get your deed.
Thank you very much. Excuse me, please.
Say, what is this anyway?
Gallantry, Jim. Gallantry. Now, come on, folks. Let's bid these lots in fast. Let's see how quickly we can build this wonder town of ours. Now, lot number 23. What do I hear? What do I bid?
A little higher? All right, that's fine. Come on, get your glasses up there, boys. Get your table set.
Never was a man in the world any finer. Home was a sin, and that's where I commit. So gather round me, girls, and let the story begin.
Hey, Professor, wait a minute.
Well, boys, we just got the results of our first election. Everything fair and square and a step forward in the administration of our fair city. For Judge Henry C. Tribble, for Mayor Bonnie Davies, for Sheriff Noisy Burkett, and for Assessor Mitch Harrigan. Unanimously! Wait a minute, that's not all. We'll celebrate. So step up to the bar, everything is free.
You know, Bonnie, you're going to make a great mayor. And Judge, from now on, we're going to have law and order, eh?
With a vengeance.
Sheriff, my hand.
Now, I'll show you another wrestling trick. You take this bottle as if it were a knife, and you're going to rip me up. You understand?
Uh-huh.
All right, now, come at me.
Ow!
Simple, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
Hey! Just listen to him out there, Steve. It's just like you said. Dig a hole for him, they'll fight the...
Say, what are you doing down there?
Just playing a little game.
Well, every man to his own taste. Hey, you, get out of here now, will you?
Yeah, get out of here.
You know, Steve, I like this handling things nice and legal. Saves a lot of trouble. It's a great idea you got there.
Just don't be too crude, Jim, or they're liable to believe the whole Civil War was just a frame-up.
Frame-up? That's good. Well, now we've got a government. Let's get busy on these water rights.
Oh, then you got the schoolmarm's property.
No, she wouldn't sell. But don't worry. I'll roust her out of there fast enough.
Now, listen, Jim. I've given the technique of being a robber baron a lot of study. Now, the main idea is to gang up on posterity, but to treat your contemporaries easily and legally.
What do you mean by that?
No rousting out. Get a bill of sale from her. Then you've got control nice and legal.
All right. You sold it to her. Now you get it back.
Me?
Nice and legal.
Oh, now, but Jim...
You can't do anything. I say you can't...
Hello, Turk.
I got the message you sent.
I'm glad to hear it.
The guy that brought it's got two busted legs. Any other skunk tries to tell me I can't start a place here, he'll find himself full of lead.
I'll call that, Turk. There's not going to be another place around here until I get good and ready to build it. And one other thing. You get out of this town tonight or I'll run you out.
That's something I'd like to see.
I see you got started sooner than I expected.
Is he dead?
Yes, Jim.
Well, now we can have a trial. Nice and legal. Judge.
Right here, Jim.
Come on, get busy.
Yes, Jim. The court will come to order.
Nice and legal.
Take off your hats.
Now, some people say that he used to walk in his sleep. But we don't believe everything we hear, do we, children?
No.
No. And anyway, the king really did do everything that he... Why, Mr. Lewis?
Oh, I'm sorry, Miss Morgan. I really didn't mean to interrupt. I thought your class would be over.
Oh. My goodness, and so it should be. It's after 3 o'clock. Very well, children. School is dismissed.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
I hope you'll forgive this intrusion.
Oh, but it's not an intrusion, Mr. Lewis. Oh, goodness.
Here, let me help you.
Oh, no, don't bother. It's all right. It'll dry in the sun. I got much wetter than this yesterday, holding Mrs. Lancey's baby.
I thought perhaps you'd care to have this volume of Browning's poems.
That's nice of you.
Well, I ran across it in my bag, and I felt I'd like to share it with someone. You know, I think books are much nicer when they're shared, don't you?
You mean like reading aloud with people? Oh, yes, indeed. God's in his heaven, all's right with the world.
I beg your pardon?
From Pippa Passes.
Oh, yes, Pippa Passes.
I think it one of Mr. Browning's best.
Oh, definitely.
Thank you very much, Mr. Lewis. It was so thoughtful of you.
Don't mention it.
Would you mind? Thank you.
Oh, here. Are you walking home?
I always do.
Oh. May I walk with you?
Oh, that's very nice of you indeed. I'd like to walk home with you. In high school in Philadelphia, when all the girls had boys to walk home with them, thank you. I used to wish. Well, what I mean is, there was one boy who would have walked home with me if he'd only stopped to think about it.
Still happy with the lot you picked?
Oh, yes. Yes, indeed. Rats that fought the dogs and killed the cats and bit the babies in the cradle and ate the cheeses out of the bats. Mr. Browning, the Pied Piper.
Oh, yes, the Pied Piper.
Yes.
Annie, may I call you Annie?
I'd like you to.
Well, there's going to be a square dance tomorrow night.
I know that.
Well, do you dance?
Well, I haven't before, but I'm sure I could learn very quickly.
Oh.
And I think it's very nice of you to ask me. I don't know why you should want me to go with you, but I'm glad that you do. Square dancing. And moonlight. Doesn't it sound romantic?
Yes, it certainly does.
There's sure to be a moon. And if you don't mind, there's something I'd like to try out. They talk about it in all the books. But I don't want to embarrass you.
I'm sure you won't.
Well, in all the books that I've read, just as the last waltz is being played, there's always sort of a pause. It's really kind of a throb. And it's then I'd like you to kiss me. But now, you needn't be afraid that I'll take it personally. Not that I mean to be impolite or anything like that, but what I really mean is that you can feel absolutely safe with me. Quiet. You think a person never had a tooth out before?
It ain't the tooth, it's what he did to put me out.
Afternoon, Miss Clara. Afternoon, Annie. Mrs. McGinnis? Mrs. McGinnis?
Come in, Annie. Come in.
Not bad. Upper bicuspid. But I'll get it.
Yes, doctor. What is it, Annie? What is it?
Oh, Mrs. McGinnis, it's wonderful. It's perfectly wonderful. It's like rain on a dusty day.
Rain, really? Well, I had
no... Oh, no, not really. It isn't that. I mean, Mrs. McGinnis, is a square dance. I'm going to it. He asked me, Mr. Lewis, do you know how to dance?
Dance?
Yes.
Well, my dear, that's how I won the doctor. Practically swept him off his feet.
Well, then you can teach me how. I bought 15 yards of muslin with the sweetest little green flower you've ever seen. Is that enough? I thought I'd get a lot in case we spoiled some. And a bustle, just like the one on your black dress. Can we make it?
Why, of course, Andy. I'll get my pattern. Oh. Gently, doctor. Gently.
Oh! Oh!
Get a sandwich.
Give me a beer.
How's she blow?
Yeah, like a 70-mile gale. She learned dancing this afternoon. Now tonight, I'm clumsy.
From here, you're a panic.
I can't carry on a conversation. I'm dull. You get that? I'm the one that's dull.
Take it easy. Hold yourself together tonight, and we're all set.
Look, I got an idea.
What?
Let's give her the town, and you and I move on with the railroad.
Give me a beer.
Hello, Hank. I've been wanting to talk to you.
Yeah, well, now's a good time, because I can't do much talking back.
I've been reading your paper. I take it you don't like the way things are run around here.
Just beginning to penetrate, eh?
And I'm almost of the opinion that we don't need a newspaper or an editor either. Now keep that in your button the next time you think of writing about me as a tyrant.
Oh, Jim, you've got the wrong idea. When I say tyrant, I mean a big man. Caesar, Nero, Napoleon. Oh, I'm in favor of tyrants. Of course, there are all kinds of tyrants. Now, you're my favorite kind. You know, the benevolent kind. Benevolence tempered by the fear of assassination.
Take your partners for a walk!
Starlight, star bright, first star I see tonight. I wish I might have the wish I wish tonight. A stove.
Stove?
It's a star. I just wish for a brand new stove for my schoolhouse.
Oh.
They're intoxicating, aren't they? The stars, I mean, and the moon. Do you think I ought to have two of them?
Two what?
Two stoves to heat my schoolhouse.
Oh, no, just one.
Oh. Isn't the dance wonderful? Do you think it protrudes too far in the back? My bustle, I mean. Miss McGinnis helped me make this dress. Do you like it?
Yes. Yes, I do.
Thank you.
Annie.
Yes, Stephen.
Do you hear what they're playing?
Yes.
It's the waltz. Well, you remember what you asked me to do?
Are you going to do it now?
Yes. There's one thing I'd like to know.
Oh, certainly, Stephen.
Well, I'd like to know if... Well, have you ever been kissed before?
No. Does that make any difference?
Well, it may come more of a surprise than you think.
Oh, but I'm not taking it personal.
Oh. All right.
Rushing around inside of me. I feel like giving presents to everyone. Birdie with a yellow bill, dust on the windowsill.
Oh, that's very good, Thomas. Put all the history books together. And here, Edward, there's King Arthur. Put in next to Pocahontas. They should make a very nice couple.
And here's Shakespeare. Ah, this bud of love by summer's ripening breath may prove a beauteous flower when next we meet.
Mush.
That's Romeo and Juliet, Edward.
It's still mush.
It will seem romantic to you someday. You'll see.
Hello.
Why, hello. How are you, Henry?
Annie, what's this I hear about you selling your property?
Yes, isn't it wonderful? Mr. Cork has given me three times the value and a lot way up on the hill, and he's moving this building, and all without charge.
Uh-huh. Our kind-hearted Mr. Cork, huh?
Yes. And as Stephen pointed out, I did buy this land for speculation.
Oh, as Stephen pointed out.
Edward, you go and help Thomas now, please.
Annie?
Yes?
Have you signed anything yet?
No, I'm going to Mr. Cork's office this afternoon.
You know, this has got me worried. Jim Cork giving anything away.
Oh, but Stephen says that...
I know, but there's something back of it all.
What is it?
I don't know. But do me a favor, will you?
Why, certainly, Henry.
You drop in at my place before you see Jim Cork. Promise?
Of course.
I may have some news for you. I hope so.
All right, you had me that time, but I bet you can't do it again. Now, come on.
Why don't you two stop it?
Get out of here, Kate.
All right, sweetheart. Whenever you're ready.
Yeah, I'll get it yet. Don't worry.
How are you, boys?
Hello, Hank. What are you doing around here? So what kind of a place is this anyway?
Mighty busy man these days, aren't you, Jim?
What do you want?
Well, I thought you might have a little news for me.
Well, I have, Hank.
Shoot.
Well, the boys have decided to run me for the legislature.
That's not news. No, I'd rather talk about something else. Say, real estate. Any big deals on? Anything that plain, simple people building homes around here might be interested in? Supposing you tell me and I'll write it down. I did have a piece of paper around here somewhere.
Keep your hands off. Now you get out of here before I throw you out.
Just wanted the piece of paper to make some notes on.
Yeah, and to find out something about my business, huh? Now get out.
All right. You know, Jim, right down the line, every tyrant has been assassinated. Caesar, the Borgias, Murat. Happens every time.
Get out!
Huh? Oh, dear.
Well, what is it, Henry? What does it mean?
It's a notice to the farmers.
Yes?
If you sell your property to Jim Cork, he'll control the water of this county. The farmers won't be able to get a drop unless they pay him for it.
So that's why I wanted my property. Why Stephen came and brought the book. And even when he kissed me, he was thinking...
I'm sorry, Annie.
Guess I've been kind of childish and silly, haven't I? But I think I've grown up. Just in this 1 minute... I'll see you later, Henry.
There. All she's got to do is sign it. By the way, she was supposed to be here by 3 o'clock. Where is she?
She said she'd be here. Oh, good afternoon, Annie.
Well, Miss Morgan, we're certainly glad to see you.
Hi, Mr. Cook.
Here, sit right here, Annie.
You've driven a rather hard bargain, Miss Morgan. And I don't know just where I'm going to come out on this proposition. But then I love the school kiddies, and they'll be much happier on top of the hill. After all, that's more important, isn't it?
Is it, Mr. Cork?
Well, I look upon this town as one great, big, happy family. In fact, we both do, don't we, Steve?
Oh, yes, indeed. Well, here's the deed.
Yes, and here's the pen, and you sign right there.
Right there.
Yes, right there. Oh, is anything wrong, Annie?
No. No, I was just thinking about something.
After all, Annie, Mr. Cork's a rather a busy man.
I know he is.
Say, will somebody please tell me what's going on around here?
Yes, Mr. Cork. I'll tell you.
Some people don't think it's very nice to go around pretending friendship for business reasons. And kissing people. When they find out they've been fooled, they feel bad. Really bad. They might even feel like breaking things. They might even feel like taking up their spaces. And as for you, Mr. Cork, let me tell you one thing. As long as I have that land, any farmer who wants to can draw all the water he needs from that river.
You can't talk to me like that. You'll do as I say.
You're making me mad, Mr. Cork. Awfully mad. I will not sign your paper. And if you try any monkey business with me, I'll take you to law.
Take me to law? Huh? You filly, you. I'll run you out of this town so fast.
Excellence in this particular should indeed be cultivated by every well-bred woman who wishes to shine in fashionable society. There is a certain subdued tone of voice which is peculiar to only well-bred persons. A loud voice is both disagreeable and vulgar. It is better to err on the side of too low rather than too loud a tone. Well, and now I see Miss Morgan is here, and she's promised to favor us by reading her favorite poem by Mr. Browning. Annie, my dear.
Oh, how lovely.
Annie, my dear?
No, thank you, Mrs. McGinnis. I am not going to read for you. Please don't ever mention Mr. Browning to me again. Mr. Browning, indeed. God's in his heaven and all's right with the world. Well, let me tell you, ladies, all is not right with the world. At least it isn't with me.
Now, as I was saying, there is a certain subdued tone of voice, peculiar only to well-written.
It's a schoolhouse, ma'am.
The schoolhouse?
The schoolhouse. Oh, fire.
This is Jim Cork's work, Annie.
Read all about the burning of the schoolhouse. Read.
Here, give me a pencil.
Thank you, Jim. How are you, Sheriff? Have a paper, my compliments. Read it. You might find it interesting. Read all about Jim Cork, arsonist.
All right, boys. Start smashing.
Here! What are you men doing here? Go on, get out of here, all of you! Go on! Stop! Oh, don't do this! Help!
Hi, Steve.
Hello, Bert.
Go on! Don't do that!
What are you doing here? Go on, get out of here. Get out of here, you...
Hold on. What happened to it?
Go on, call
what
it, doctor!
What
is
that?
Oh,
off his coat.
His coat?
Oh, yes. His... Oh, my arm, doctor.
His arm.
Oh, do something.
Hey, get some water, hot water.
Oh, this is the last straw. We're going to do something to stop this.
We certainly are. Well, I bet.
Glory, glory, hallelujah. We'll hang Jim Cork to a sour apple tree as we go.
And now, the purpose of this meeting is that we, the better citizens, must face our responsibility.
We've had enough of Jim Cox, and we're here to see that some way he's put in jail.
That's all very well, but who's going to put him there?
Why, whoever puts people in jail. That's quite unimportant. The fact is that they have beat up our editor, and they have burned down my schoolhouse.
And now they want us to pay for the water.
Oh, yes, but you don't need to worry about that, because anyone who wants water can take it through my property.
Well, if I know anything about it, Cork will shoot the first man that tries it.
Oh, no, he won't, because he'll be in jail.
He certainly will.
Well, you've got to convict him first, and that takes a jury.
Then we'll have a jury. That's a simple matter.
Why, of course it is. And Dr. McGinnis will be the foreman.
Who? Me?
Of course.
Now, what about the rest of you? Who will be on the jury?
Well, Cork won't stop at anything, ma'am.
Well, what of it? Are you a low-down coward?
Bill's right, Mrs. Ames. Going up against that gang of gunmen would be the same as signing your own death certificate.
Gentlemen, it can't be that you're afraid. Why, there must be 12 men in this town who aren't afraid.
Well, there evidently aren't. A classic example of mass cowardice if ever I saw one, including Dr. McGinnis. Oh, if we only had a woman's jury, we'd soon fix Jim Cox, hash.
Mrs. McGinnis, that's what we need. We'll have a woman's jury. That ought to be very simple, and none of this men's business about being open-minded and not prejudiced, as they say. We want a good, prejudiced jury.
I know, but my dear, we... For goodness sakes,
Good afternoon, ladies.
What is the meaning of this intrusion?
We heard you were going to have a meeting, so I thought you might like to have some refreshments. At the same time, I'd like to introduce Steve Lewis, our candidate for the legislature, a fellow all your husband's going to vote for.
We want no part of you or your candidate.
Jim Cox, who burned up that school?
Who beat up Hank Ford?
But you needed a good beating yourself.
Ladies, restraint, if you please.
Yes, indeed. We don't want to start any trouble. That isn't the way we want to do it. We want to do it by law. Mr. Cork, a jury is going to convict you, and it's going to be a woman's jury.
A woman's jury? That's good, that is. Go on, Steve, tell her. Tell her what's wrong with it. Go on. Well,
Just what is wrong with it, Mr. Lewis?
Well, I'm very much afraid that ladies can't possibly sit on a jury.
Why not?
Because under the law, only those who have the franchise may serve as jurors. That means the right to vote. Therefore, anyone incapable of voting in an election is also ipso facto barred from serving on a jury.
Is that so?
Yes, it is. And I suggest if you intend going into public life, you start by reading Blackstone.
Oh, it's Blackstone now, is it? It isn't Mr. Browning anymore. Well, let me tell you something, Mr. Lewis. Blackstone or no Blackstone, we'll have women on that jury and they'll convict Mr. Cork.
Convict me? Hello, Steve.
In other words, he said we couldn't do it.
Steve was right, Annie. You're not the first woman who's tried to have a voice in the running of their town. But there's laws, Annie. Laws men made. And under them, a woman is just a female, a chattel, a piece of property without any rights at all.
Well, I certainly...
Oh, their laws let you live and breathe. And I guess they think you should be thankful for that much.
But I'm not at all thankful, Henry. There's something just boiling up inside of me. I think I'm just plain mad. I'd like to hit somebody.
Sure. But organizations have to be started. And before things can be changed, bills have to be passed.
I'm not so smart as you are, Henry. Maybe that's why I don't want to wait. When I see something wrong, I want to stop it right away.
Thank you, my friend, thank you. And as your representative, I will devote my entire effort to the cause of better government.
I'm going to take that train to Cheyenne next Monday. I'll get a bill passed, so that's what has to be done, and I'll be back by Thursday. Bye, Henry, and take good care of yourself.
Annie!
One, two, three, four!
We're living in town of Arnold. We're making corn to a sour apple tree. And we go marching on.
You know, Annie, sometimes it's fun fighting windmills, and sometimes you get hurt way down deep inside of you. You know, there are hundreds who've tried what you're going to try. I wish I could talk you out of it.
Why, Henry, I'm surprised at you. Now, supposing Columbus had allowed the Queen and the people to discourage him just because they were silly enough to think they lived on a saucer. And there was Mr. Newton to
Henry. All right, Annie, all right.
Well?
Here's that bill I drew up for you in case you do have a chance to use it.
Oh, thank you, Henry.
And while you're gone, Annie, Mr. Clark is going to take water through your property.
Well, good for you, Mr. Clark. You go right ahead and take all you need.
You can trust me, miss.
Walbert!
Hurry on, Annie. Go on. Get on the train.
Goodbye, Steve. Lots of good luck.
Thanks, boss.
Take care of him, Annie.
Yeah,
there's your lunch.
Thank you. And don't worry about me. I'll be back on Thursday.
All right.
Goodbye, Henry.
Goodbye. Bye.
Do you mind my sitting here?
Why should I? It's a public convention. You may sit any place you like.
Thank you. Annie, why don't you be a sweet little girl and go back to your school kids and books and friends and leave these things to people who know what they're all about?
Mr. Lewis, will you please not annoy me anymore?
I've never wanted to annoy you any time. Just that you have a remarkable talent for getting your nose in the machinery. Annie. Annie.
Well, Mr. Lewis.
At least let me give you one piece of advice. If you insist upon going to the legislature, you should do everything you can to make a good impression. You should try to be as pretty as possible. Annie, if you don't mind my saying so, you really ought to get a new hat. Oh, no, Annie, wait just a minute, please.
Will you please leave me alone? Just go away from me. Go away, go away.
Is he bothering you, miss?
Bothering? He's the most bothersome man who ever lived. Excuse me, please, sir.
Oh, one of them, huh?
What's the fight about?
I don't know.
Let's get in it.
What are you waiting for?
Glad to see you.
Oh, how are you?
Hello, Mr. Lewis.
Hello.
Hello, Sam.
Hello, Steve. What's the matter? Nosebleed?
Excuse me, please. You'll get used to these stairs. They're good for you. Build up the muscles in your legs.
Oh, I won't mind them. I'm a firm believer in exercise.
And this dark-haired fella, he put his arm around me, waved a flag, and said, I take possession in the name of San Salvatore. Now, what did he mean by that?
This is as good a room as we have. There's a lump in the mattress, but if you'll find you can curl around it, just experiment and don't go calling me and complaining. The rent's always in advance every Monday, and we got one strict rule. No singing after 2 o'clock in the morning.
I'm Elsie, and this is Myrtle and Gertie.
Well, how do you do? I'm Annie Morgan.
You're new here, aren't you, honey?
Yes, I am. I'm going to be here for only a few days. I have to hurry right back to Laraville. I have a lot of business to attend to.
Well, business good up there, huh?
Yes, indeed. It's booming.
You don't say. Looks like you got out in a hurry.
I did. The ladies felt I should lose no time. They all came down to put me on the train.
Same thing happened to me once.
Of course, the men didn't want me to go.
Well, maybe we could get you on at the palace. We're dancing over there.
Dancing is wonderful, isn't it? Except that the men get awfully tired.
No, the men ain't what they used to be.
Well, come on over to my room, have a drink, and let's get acquainted.
That's nice of you, Elsie. Thank you very much, but I don't drink. Do you think this hat would be better without the feather?
Why don't you try the feather without the hat? Come on, girls, I'll set them up. We'll see you later, dearie.
Thank you.
I'll be darned if I'll change it.
Steve, here's a fellow you ought to know. Larry Dunbar, big cattleman from Carson County. Steve is Jim Cork's lawyer.
How are you? How are you? This is going to be a new experience for me, riding herd on a bunch of laws, but I think I'm going to like it.
Sure you will.
The house will come to order.
I beg your pardon. Is this where the legislature is meeting?
Yes, ma'am. They'll be taking oath now.
Oh, thank you very much.
Members of the House will please rise. Raise your right hands and repeat after me. I do solemnly swear to support the Constitution of the United States of America.
I do solemnly swear to support the Constitution of the United States of America.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties of my office to the best of my ability.
And that I will faithfully discharge the duties of my office to the best of my ability.
Gentlemen, those were very fine words. I hope that each and every one of you realizes the importance of them.
Young lady, the visitor sit over there, back of the rail.
Oh, but I'm not a visitor. I'm here on business.
You're not a member, so you sit over there in the back.
Very well. If you choose to make an issue of it.
Mr. Speaker?
Mr. Right there, child.
Mr. Speaker and gentlemen, I make a motion that we don't allow smoking while the assembly is in session.
Are you crazy?
Why, I've been smoking for 20 years, and I don't intend giving it up now, motion or no motion.
Why, I can't even think when I ain't got a cigar.
Mr. Speaker, I would like to suggest to the gentleman from Burke County that tobacco has been a solace and one of the greatest boons to mankind since Sir Walter Raleigh first introduced its use. Tobacco is one of the...
Mr. Cummings, you haven't the floor.
Gentlemen, you don't understand. The first thing that we want to do is to make a good impression upon the taxpayers. Now this no smoking resolution will look mighty good upon the books.
Well, that's different. All those in favor of the no-smoking resolution, say aye.
Aye.
Contrary. Motion's been passed unanimously. Gentlemen, put out your pipes and cigars.
Your Honor.
Mr. Speaker, Mr. Dunbar. I'm going to positively refuse to come back here unless I can have some comfort. We've got to have swivel chairs and desks.
Very sound idea, very sound.
Now, wait a minute. How do you think that's going to look on the books?
The devil with the books.
Mr. Speaker, I think the suggestion of the gentleman from Carson County needs careful consideration. We must not forget that this is the taxpayers' money we are so recklessly spending.
I suppose you know you're all talking a lot of nonsense. I have never heard such a lot of silly talk in all my life. It's ridiculous.
I would like to call the attention of the speaker to the fact that visitors are not allowed to interrupt the proceedings of the House.
I am not a visitor. I am more a part of this assembly than desks are. I have something
to say. May I call the attention of the speaker to the fact that no resolution has yet been passed approving the presence of women in the visitor section? And I move that until such resolution is passed, the young lady retire to the hall.
I second the motion.
Will you please stop making motions while I'm talking?
You've heard the motion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Contrary. Young woman, you will please retire to the hall. And no back talk.
Very well. But would you please hurry up the resolution about letting me back in? I have something important to talk about, and I haven't much time.
Yes, up there in Washington, the colonel was a mighty handy man, putting them words one after another. Why, he used to keep talking to them senators 8 and 9 hours at a stretch.
Talk? My goodness, don't they ever do anything?
Well, sometimes for a little exercise, they lay cornerstones. Of course, getting the votes is the main thing. After that, they just kind of relax.
Excuse me.
Therefore, in the strictest sense of economy, solid mahogany would be more.
They're still talking about desks.
Yes, and that goes on.
I thought they were going to pass a resolution to let me back in.
Did they promise?
No, not exactly.
That's bad. Because even if they did promise, it'll still be kind of vague.
Oh, I haven't any time to waste. I have to get my bill passed and be back home by Thursday.
Mighty fast work, ma'am. You must be in a powerful hurry.
Yes, I have to be back and put a man in jail. Goodness, what's that? What are they doing?
Sound like they's adjourned. The only time motion is unanimous is when they's adjourned. Oh. Pardon me, ma'am. I got to get these heads.
I think we need a very good first.
Yes.
Pammy, you'll be happy to know we get our desks in 2 weeks. Good day.
Oh, Your Honor, I have a bill I want introduced.
What district, ma'am?
Larryville District.
You'll have to speak to Mr. Stephen Lewis. He introduces all the Larryville bills. Good day, ma'am.
Oh, but... Oh, sir.
At your service, miss.
I hope you will be. I have a bill I want introduced. Will you please help me?
Well, miss, what sort of a bill is it?
A bill that will give women the franchise. That means that it will give the women the right to vote.
Women's suffrage. So that's what you want, is it? That scatterbrained idea of women voting. Shoving themselves into politics. Something they know nothing about. Why, but... you women don't know how to think. If you had two ideas, your heads would split open. Now let me tell you something. Woman's place is in the home. Having babies. Darning a good man's socks. Doing the washing. And if you were someone that belonged to me, I'd give you a darn good spanking.
But, sir, I...
Ma'am, don't you pay no attention. Seems politicians have a painful lot of talk in them. They just got to get it out. I sure wish I could help you.
Thank you, George.
But he sure said a mouthful.
Is a gentleman in the parlor? Oh, it's you.
Annie. Annie. Come in here a minute, please.
I don't think
please.
I have...
Here, Annie. Sit here. Annie, I want to be friends with you.
Are you going to help me?
Well, I'd like to help you.
Then
not your bill, Annie. Not what you're here for, but you.
So, you're up to one of your tricks again.
Oh, no, I swear I'm not.
But you won't help me in the legislature.
Well, it wouldn't make any difference whether I did or not. It's an impossible idea, Annie. Now, please try and see that.
No, I...
And as a friend of yours, it hurts me to see you up here wearing yourself out. Making... Well, I'm going to have to say it, Annie. Making a ridiculous figure of yourself.
I am...
Now, wait. Hear me through before you start throwing things.
But I can't stop now. All those friends of mine are depending on me.
Annie, I told you on the train you're a sweet, silly child. Why, instead of worrying about other people, you should have someone to take care of you. You should be married and have a good man to look after you. Why, you weren't meant to be an old maid. There's too much woman in you, Annie. Real, honest woman. Yeah. And you'd be pretty, too. And darn pretty if you'd fix yourself up. Do something with your hair, make it sort of fancy, wear some attractive clothes. Oh, you could do a lot with yourself if you'd take the trouble.
You think so?
Why, sure. And I'll bet back in Larryville there's a dozen men that would marry you.
Oh, you do you?
Oh, no, Annie.
Will you just get right out of here and take your advice with you?
Annie.
And please don't tell me what I should wear and
now
how
look,
I should look, and don't ever speak to me again.
No,
ever.
Annie.
I hope you didn't let him see you cry.
I'm not crying.
No, of course you're not.
I'm just mad. I'm real mad.
Mm-hmm. You must be pretty stuck on him to get that mad.
I hate him.
I just hate him. He's done everything he could to stop me ever since I came here. And he says I don't have to be an old maid, even though I don't wear my hair the way he likes me. He wants it fancy. I never hated anyone so much in all my life. Not even the man in Philadelphia who beat his dog.
No, wait a minute, kid. Take it easy. Tell me all about it, and I may be able to patch things up.
I don't want things patched up. I want them all ripped apart. Oh, Elsie, I've just got to get that bill in suit now. So as I can show him, I've got to find some way.
Well, I don't know much about it, but politicians are men, and men are the same every place. They don't give away nothing for nothing. Now, if you was a man, you might get them over by giving them votes or cigars. But being a woman, well,
if I just knew someone in there.
You mean someone in the legislature?
Yeah.
Well, if that's all you need, your troubles are over.
You mean you know one of them?
One of them? I know them all.
Me? Introduce a bill for woman's suffrage? Oh, no.
Oh, yes. You'll do it for little Elsie.
Oh, why, they'd laugh me right out of the hall. Elsie, take it easy, will you? Remember, I'm in the public eye.
You'll be in their eye like a hot cinder unless you help my little friend, like I helped you get elected.
Yes, I know, dear.
Babykin.
I think it's wonderful to see two people so fond of each other. You both must be very proud.
Oh, I am. I'd like to shout it from the housetops. In fact, I'd like to visit Babykin's hometown and shout about it there.
All right. Give me the bill, ma'am.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Silver. There you are. I do hope you'll invite me to your wedding.
Yeah, but Elsie, please take her away. Just take her away.
Good morning, Miss Morgan.
Good morning, George.
I didn't expect to see you again.
Well, you see, they're going to introduce my bill this morning.
Oh. Oh, no, you don't. You can't go in there without a pass.
Oh, that. Signed by Mr. Stover.
Mr. Griswold.
Yes.
Mr. Hammett.
Here.
And Mr. Harrell.
Yes.
The House will come to order.
Mr. Speaker.
Mr. Jerry Stover.
Mr. Speaker. I have a bill here I'd like to introduce. A bill to extend the suffrage to women.
Suffrage? Let's come over here, Silver.
Who never think of that?
Come on over and take the Bill for Women's Suffrage. An act to grant to the women of the territory the right of suffrage and to hold office. Be it enacted, Section 1, that every woman of the age of 21 years residing in this territory may at every election to be holden under the laws thereof cast her vote. Section 2, this act shall take effect and be enforced from and after its passage.
Mr. Speaker.
Mr. Stephen Lewis.
I move that the bill for women's suffrage be referred to the Judiciary Committee.
I second the motion. You have heard the motion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Contrary? Very well. The bill for women's suffrage has been referred to the Judiciary Committee with Mr. Stephen Lewis as chairman.
My bill, but they turned it over to Mr. Lewis and the committee, and Mr. Lewis is my enemy.
Oh, that's bad.
What will happen to it?
Well, they'll just kick it around and report it out on the floor without comment. And when a bill comes out without comment, it's dead, buried, and forgotten.
Oh, dear. Then we'll have to get some comment.
Yes, and it appears to me we's gonna need a whole mess of comment.
What would they do in Washington?
Well, the colonel always got to the highest man.
The speaker?
No, the best, highest man that wastes the biggest influence.
Yes?
This calls for the governor.
The governor? Of course. Why didn't I think of it? I'll see him right away.
Ma'am?
Yes?
If you do it the way the politicians do,
yes,
like stalking a possum, slip up on them kind of easily, then wham.
Wham?
Yes, the governor's giving the ball tonight.
Oh, then I'll see him there.
Of course, you got to have an engraved invitation, else the butler won't let you in. I seen some in them gentlemen's pocket in my cloakroom.
George, if anyone had told me 2 weeks ago that I'd accept stolen goods.
Yes, ma'am, I know you'd feel that way. Excuse me, ma'am. I was going to be there, too. They's hired me as a waiter. Begging your pardon, ma'am, the ball's going to be excruciatingly fancy. The lady's going to be dressed in a mess of elegance. You know, the proper kind of wham.
Now, don't you worry, George. I'll get a dress, and one with a great deal of the proper kind of wham. Goodbye, and I'll see you tonight.
We're from Paris. You can be just as lively as you dare. But if you are, come see some stars. We'll show you just what they do about us there. We are the ladies from Paris. At home on anybody's knee. We've got what it is you're missing, romance. And a lot of kissing. We'd like to tease you, hug you, and squeeze you. Just like it's done in Paris.
Now, don't worry about a thing.
No.
Well, this is
nice. Squeaky was
that? Hey!
Oh, you're doing it like that. Get out.
I'm getting something for Annie.
Annie?
Good grief. Is she joining the show?
No, I'm not, Gertrude. I'm going to the governor's ball.
My, ain't we fancy?
Yes, and I need a dress. It's very important.
Annie's doing a job for all of us. She's going to get us votes.
Votes for what?
Votes for whatever we want to vote for. Annie says we're all chattels.
Well, of all the nerves.
Slaves of men.
As if we didn't know.
Is she just finding that out? And when we get the vote, we'll be just as good as men. We'll have our say right out. And that's why Annie's going to ball to get it for us. So we got to dress her up so she can dazzle them. Now, come on. Y'all got to help.
Why? Sure. Come on. Right.
I'd have never have thought it.
Careful now. Don't muff it.
I feel naked.
You look naked. You look grand.
Oh, I don't know. I've never been to a fashionable ball before. I don't think I can do it.
But you need some nerve medicine.
Don't worry, dearie. You can do it.
Sure, just be snooty.
But you need some strengthening tonic. I hate to give it away, but it sure looks to me like you need it.
What kind of medicine is it?
Just general strengthening. Elegant for the nerves. I call it Pepto. A gentleman give it to me.
How much do I take?
Oh, just as much as you can hold. You see, it kills the germs inside your nerves.
Very well.
Atta girl. Oh, there, dearie.
That's awful.
I know it, but that's because it's good medicine. Now drink some more.
I can't. It burns too much.
That's part of the treatment. I stand a lot of its burning, just so as I can keep my health.
You
sure do.
Annie? Why, thought Annie was here. Meet the new addition.
Well, fuzzle my buzzle. Talk about the sow's ear. Look. Look what comes. Might be anything. Anything that's horrible.
Telegram. For me.
Here, let me do it. Clark shot dead this morning.
I knew it was something horrible.
We have the evidence if you have the vote. Hank Foreman.
John Clark shot dead.
Friend of yours, honey?
Shot. Just for taking water for his children. Oh, that wicked man. That awful Jim Cork. Now, I've got to go to the ball. I've just got to go. That's all there is to it.
You want some of this medicine?
Healthy? I think I do.
Hey, Elsie, come out of there. It's time for your number.
Go stick your head in a bucket. We're getting the vote, and from now on, we're not taking orders from no man. Now, get out of here. Go on, get out of here. Get out!
Get out!
My little flower. Pet, this is Mr. Lewis. But be careful of him. He's quite a heartbreaker.
How do you do, Miss Dunbar?
Nice idea, the governor having the ball here at the hotel, isn't it? Makes everybody sort of feel at home.
Yes. Would you honor me with this dance?
Miss Annie Morgan.
Aren't we gonna dance?
Oh, yes.
I don't recall her. Who is she?
Morgan, Morgan. She must be the French singer, Governor.
Governor Howard, your admirer, sir.
Mademoiselle.
Governor, I hesitate. I hesitate to say it, but you're so different from what I imagined.
Oh.
Your beard is beautiful. You must brush it a great deal. And you're not old at all. Well, you must have worked very hard as a little boy to climb so high, so fast.
Oh, but I...
Oh, it's a brilliant affair, isn't it? Just brilliant. Governor Howard, I'd be honored to dance with you.
It's my honor, dear lady.
How do you do, Stephen? How nice to see you again.
Do you sing in French?
Well, I hadn't thought of it. Why?
Well, those little French songs are so stimulating.
Yes. Oh, warm, isn't it? Yes. My blood seems heated. It's running up and down, like ants in a tree. Governor, could we go someplace where it's cool?
Yes. Oh, yes. Would you like to step out on the terrace?
Thank you. Why, this is lovely, isn't it? I'm awfully glad to be alone with you.
Well, that's very nice of you.
Yes, isn't it? But then, you see, I have my reasons. I just had to talk with you privately, and well, that's why I came here tonight. I do hope you're not going to be angry with me.
Angry?
Yes.
Oh, my dear young lady.
Well, you see, I really want you to help me with my bill. The bill is to give women the franchise. That means that they can vote.
Women's suffrage?
Yes. Now, just pretend for a minute that you're Mr. Lincoln, and you're freeing the slaves, and... Why, Governor, you'd even look like him if your beautiful beard were darker.
Would I really?
Yes, indeed. And now you will help me, won't you?
Well, I'm afraid there's nothing I can do. The members of the legislature must vote on the bill in the usual way. You should do some lobbying.
Lobbying? Yes.
Well, I'm afraid I'll have to join my other guests. Shall we go inside?
Oh, yes, of course. Governor, would you mind very much if I just sort of stayed out here and thought over all you said?
Well, of course not. May I have another dance later?
Oh, yes.
Thank you.
George.
She's doing fine.
No, I'm not. I'm not getting anywhere. He told me he couldn't help me. And he told me to go in the lobby again. Oh, George, I've sat in that lobby so long already.
No, ma'am. He means to lobby. That's the way they get everything done in Washington.
Is it? How do they do it?
Well, it's this way.
Yes?
Lobbying is making the use of the fact that the Republican hates the Democrat, and the Democrat hates the Republican. Mm-hmm. So they're already suspicious of each other. So you got to just help them along.
Help along?
Yes. It's sort of like taking two loaded dice and giving one to each party. Mm-hmm. You just stick around and watch them.
Yeah.
And then, wham!
Again, George?
Oh.
The governor told me the funniest story about the Democrats.
Is that so, ma'am?
You are a Republican, aren't you?
Born and bred, ma'am.
Well, the governor said that the Republicans are so smart, they're much smarter than the Democrats.
Is that so, ma'am?
He said the Republicans are all going to vote for the bill tomorrow.
What bill is that? I can't keep track of them. You see, I'm a builder of a trade.
The woman's suffrage bill.
stoop.
I didn't think anyone wanted that bill to go through.
Oh, of course they don't. They'll turn it down. But it will look so good on the record for the Republicans to vote for it. They'll get the credit for being liberal, and they still won't lose anything. Because they'll be letting the Democrats vote it down.
Yeah, I see. Well, that's a right smart idea, ma'am. A right smart idea. Now, who thought of that?
Oh, that's a secret. And you mustn't talk about it. The Democrats mustn't suspect.
You can trust me, ma'am.
Oh, thank you.
Miss Morgan, I'd like to have the next dance with you.
I'm sorry, Mr. Lewis. The next dance is taken. I have so much respect for the Democrats. You are a Democrat, aren't you?
A fighting one, ma'am.
Oh, I knew you would be. And I wanted to tell you how right your word has sold me for the suffrage bill.
Oh, now, ma'am.
Yes, yes, the governor himself convinced me how ridiculous it is. But he hopes the Democrats will vote for it.
Vote for it?
Oh, yes, don't you see? Just for the record. And let the Republicans vote against it.
Oh, I see, ma'am. Yeah. Well, I don't get the idea.
Well, the idea is this. That we Republicans ought to take credit for having a liberal point of view.
But supposing it goes through.
But it won't.
Now, the point is, we let them vote it down. And we take the credit for it.
That's a mighty good idea. Mighty good.
And you should be the one to introduce it.
Mighty good.
I don't think you have a chance, ma'am. But you can count on me. And tell Elsie I'll spread it like gospel.
Oh, thank you, Mr.
Excuse
Stover.
Me, Stover. Annie, I want to talk to you.
Oh, you do you, Mr. Lewis? Well, I'm sorry.
Yes, I most certainly do.
Now, what are you butting in for, Lewis?
This is none of your business, Stover.
Oh, is that so? Well, I might just as well lay you out right here.
Oh, Mr. Stover, please don't. He's very easily handled. He's just like a spoiled child. Thank you.
Of course, you know you're making quite a spectacle of yourself.
All the other gentlemen seem to like it.
Quite the belle of the ball.
So I've been told all evening.
I want to talk to you. Come on.
Where?
Out here, out on the terrace.
Oh, I don't know, Mr. Lewis. I went for a walk with you at one dance, and it wasn't very amusing.
Well, you're coming along, whether it's amusing or not. Annie, something's gone wrong with me, and you're to blame for it.
I?
Yes, you. Until you came along and bought that lot, I was a peaceful, contented man that knew what he wanted and was out to get it the quickest way he knew how. But eating my dinner lately, I've begun to see your face on the plate. And tonight you've taken possession of the entire room and of me. Yes, tonight it's been you. You ever since you first walked down those stairs. Annie, I could throttle you with my bare hands. Something's really got to be done about you, Annie.
No, I don't think the second time will be as surprising as the first.
No, but I mean it this time. Well, you're lovely, Annie. You're beautiful. Remember that first time? You said you wanted to give presents? I feel like that now. I'd like to send presents to everyone in Larryville.
Oh.
Annie.
I almost forgot. You still wanted Jim Cork's man.
Yes, but Annie...
I got a present tonight from Larryville, and it isn't very nice. Here, read it. It ought to make you very proud. Go on, read it. Good morning, George. These are my friends.
Why, Miss Morgan, I hardly knew you. You look so grand.
Oh, do you think so?
And she's going to keep looking grand if we have anything to do with it.
Come along, Elsie. Thank you.
Come on. Mr. Burdett?
Here.
Mr. Stover?
Here.
Mr. Byron?
Here.
Mr. Carlisle?
Here.
Mr. Carlton?
Present.
Mr. Christian?
Here.
Mr. Cuthbert?
Here.
Mr. Davidson?
Here.
Mr. Dearborn?
Here.
Look, there's Squeegee. Yeah. Hello, Squeegee. Here.
Mr. Edgar?
Yeah.
Mr. Lewis? Mr. Lewis? Mr. Lewis? Mr. Crowley?
There's Tommy. Hi, Tommy.
Here.
We where you been lately?
Gee, they're a solemn bunch of lunkheads, ain't they? What are they doing, checking them in?
Looks like a schoolroom, don't it?
Mr. Harrell!
If the visitors don't mind being quiet, I'll declare this body is now in session.
I wonder where he is.
Who?
Mr. Lewis.
Mr. Speaker. Mr. Right there, child.
Mr. Speaker,
in the absence of Mr. Stephen Lewis, I have been asked to report on this bill for woman's suffrage that was referred to the Judiciary Committee.
That's us. That's our bill. They're going to do it now.
That committee, composed entirely of members of the Democratic Party, recommends that this bill be passed.
He's for us. Did you hear that? Atta boy, Ike.
Order, order. This woman's suffrage will be a step forward in our civilization. This is an act worthy of our new land where the pioneer women face the same hardships side by side with our men. If they endure these hardships, they deserve equal rights.
Pay no attention. Just window dressing. They're set to vote against it.
Mr. Speaker. I'm a man who has always been for the ladies. And I am convinced they ought to have the vote. The Republican Party will always stand for progress. I go on record as being in favor of the bill.
He's a dang-bang liar. He's set to vote against it, and he knows it.
Gentlemen, you are aware that this is one of the most controversial issues of the day. The Assembly seems paralyzed. Doesn't anyone want to comment? Very well. Do I hear a motion?
I move that the bill for woman suffrage be put to a vote by secret ballot.
I second the motion.
Gentlemen, you realize this is a very unusual procedure. However, you have heard the motion. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Contrary? Very well. The clerk will prepare the ballot.
Is it or isn't it, for criminy sakes?
Impossible. Have you gone daft? But that can't be. It just can't be. Are you sure?
Yourself.
The bill for woman suffrage has been passed unanimously.
I think we better have a drink. Recess till 2:30.
What happened?
I don't know. I thought they were going to vote against it.
Well, what did happen?
Something must have slipped up somewhere.
Uncle Bill. Uncle Bill, now look.
All a mystery to me.
Oh, Miss Morgan, congratulations.
Thank you, George.
I've never seen anyone learn politics so fast.
Do you know what happened to Mr. Lewis?
No, I don't. He just went.
He just went?
Yes, went.
You don't know where?
No, I don't.
Oh, come on, dearie. We're going to celebrate.
Goodbye, George. And thank you so much for everything.
Oh, not at all, ma'am.
Oh, come on, honey.
Hey, look who's coming.
Hello, Steve. What are you doing here?
Where's Jim?
He was in the back room. I wonder what's the matter with him.
Well, hello, Steve. When did you get in? Anything happen up there?
No, it happened here. Jim, I don't like being crossed.
Crossed? What are you talking about?
Just this. There wasn't going to be any rough stuff. We had that out once, and for my side, I meant it. And then I hear about Clark being shot.
Oh, that?
Yeah, that, and I don't like it. I was willing to go along if you played smart and let me call the moves. But when you lose your head and start plugging farmers in the back, I'm through.
Now, look, Steve.
Now I'm all washed up, get me?
I resigned up at the legislature and I'm moving on. I just came back to tell you that.
Now, wait a minute, Steve. Let me explain. I promise I'll stay smart from now on. I promise you I'll never lose my temper again. I promise... Say, what's going on out there?
Well, hello, Mr. Tyrant, Mr. Assemblyman. Have you heard the news? It's passed.
Passed? What's passed?
Annie, put it over on you, my fine feathered friends. Woman suffrage is passed. Do you get that? The women have the vote. Can you understand that?
Votes for women passed?
By a unanimous vote of the Assembly.
Why, they can't do that. Do you know anything about this?
So help me.
Well, how did it happen?
Well, that's what I'd like to know.
Oh, you would you? You walk out of the Assembly and they pass votes for women. You were going to take care of everything. Sure, you took care of everything fine. If I had to send a horse up there, he'd have more sense. You and your being legal.
Ah, but you haven't heard the telegram. Glad you have evidence against Mr. Cork, because woman's suffrage passed unanimously. Will arrive on tomorrow's train, Annie. Bless her little heart.
Why, that little... I'll show her. I'm still running this town, and I'm going to run it my way. And without you, you're telling me you're through? You bet your sweet life you're through. And you better get out of here while you're still able. So they're going to try and get me, eh? All right. I'll show them. I'll run that school ma'am out of this town so fast, she thinks she was shot out of a 45, and all the rest of them that want votes for women. Mike, Noisy, Sam, Barney, come on.
Is it true you're moving on, Steve?
Yeah. Well, not for a while yet. I don't want to miss any excitement. Come on, take a walk with me, Hank.
Of course, I still don't see why my life should interest you so much. But since it seems to, I'm glad to tell you everything I can remember. Now, where was I?
Your mother was just suffering from arteriosclerosis.
Oh, yes. Well, that's a very dreadful disease.
Yes, ma'am. But could we skip a few years?
When did you become interested in politics?
Oh, I'm not interested in politics. I think that's silly. All this business about the Democrats hating the Republicans, it's such nonsense. What I'm really interested in is putting Mr. Jim Cork in jail. And that's why Mr. Fitzpatrick here is coming with me. He's a special prosecutor, and he's going to do it, aren't you?
What are your ambitions, ma'am?
Just how did you put it over? We don't seem to be able to get that straight. Will you be going to Washington, ma'am?
I beg your pardon?
Will you be going to Washington?
Oh, no. No, I'm going to Larryville.
Don't make trouble.
For mercy's sake, it's Noisy Burkhead. He's one of the Mr. Fitzpatrick. You'll have to put him in jail, too.
Well, if it ain't our little Annie. Going back to town with your votes for women, huh? Well, sister, that's one thing you ain't gonna do. You're coming with us. Come on.
I most certainly am not.
Oh, yes, you are. Larryville's getting too hot to hold you. And as sheriff, I'm gonna take care of you. They call it protective custody. Come on.
Why, Mr. Burkhead, leave me alone. Leave me alone!
Come on!
Leave me alone, and I will not go
back here! Come on!
Leave me alone!
Hey! Look what's coming!
Look out, man!
You're the posse! Don't shoot! You might hit her!
David!
Hey,
tremendous moment of our lives.
Now, wait a minute. You all listen to me. I'm tired of you yapping and yawling women. I don't want to lose my temper, but there's not going to be any celebration for votes for women. Oh, or for Annie Morgan either. Because she's not coming back into this town. And if you females make any trouble, I'm going to put you on that train
And send you far, far away.
Which is cough, ma'am?
Cough. Oh, there he is. Right over there. That's
all right. Come on, Lily.
Judge, look, something must have gone wrong.
Cough, you're under arrest.
I'm what?
Take him away, boys.
Oh, you can't do this to me.
Now, one moment, please.
Oh,
please.
For the first time in the history of jurisprudence, women are seated on a jury. And your shoulders are weighed with a grave responsibility.
Okay.
You have heard the evidence.
Excuse me, Judge. Oh, Bill. Thank you, Judge.
As I was saying, you have heard the evidence. And if you feel beyond all reasonable doubt that the defendant is guilty as charged, then you will bring in a verdict of guilty. If, on the other hand, the testimony is not entirely clear, then you are entitled to a review of the evidence. If, however, there are no questions, but if you feel a reasonable doubt as to the defendant's guilt, you will bring in a verdict of not guilty. The jury will now retire to consider the verdict.
Oh, but, Your Honor, we have reached our verdict, haven't we, ladies?
Oh, yes, ladies.
Well, do you find the defendant guilty? Or not guilty?
We find the defendant guilty as charged.
You can't do this to me! A woman's jury is illegal! It can't be! It's all!
This is a new hat. Do you like it?
Why, yes, yes. It's lovely, Annie.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, Lord!
Well, goodbye, Annie.
Oh, no, Stephen. Oh, I know it's very terrible of me to say this, but I love you, Stephen, and I felt that you loved me, and if you don't ask me to marry you, then I'll do something disgraceful and...
But, Annie, I can't marry a famous politician.
Oh, but I'm not a famous politician, and I'm not going to be. I'll stay home and darn your socks and cook your food and take care of the children and help you run for governor and... Oh, Stephen, you look wonderful with a beard. Oh, Stephen.